Hello everyone, welcome back to Naomi's Bookshelf. We are going to discuss my thoughts on the Sherlock Holmes novels series today. So I have spent the last 4 months reading Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle with Berna from Berna's Bookish Adventures, and I wanted to kind of wrap up my reading experience of the Sherlock Holmes novels. Now, this is something where I have read them before, but I haven't read them in a while. I didn't remember some things. I did remember certain aspects of books, but I did not remember them all. Now, this series, I felt like is very Victorian times. It is written in, for the most part, in the Victorian age, but it definitely reflects the times with its racism comments, with its sexist comments, with the way people are treated, the poor versus the rich. It's an unfortunate thing, but it definitely reflects the time, and it reflects what people thought about of other people or other faiths, of other religions, of other ethnicities. It's very reflective in this book series. Now, I want to talk about some highlights from this series, reading this experience. I really, really loved, and I gotta say this, I really loved seeing the development of the relationship between Watson and Sherlock. When they become mere acquaintances at the beginning, to being best friends and actual partners by the end of it at the Valley of Fear. I really loved seeing that development of a relationship. Now, I have not read most of the short stories. I have read a few here and there, but I have not read the majority of them. So I do need to read them, but I want to talk about how the novels work in my opinion. Now, when it comes to Watson and Sherlock as a duo, I think that they really can balance each other well. I think Watson has this humanity aspect to him. He really brings out this soft side, this human nature side. And why would people do these things? Because of the human nature. And then Sherlock obviously brings the logical side to it. He brings the analytical side. And it's definitely an interesting comparison between the two. Now, you can see, at least I could see as the series went on, that you can see that Watson develops this logical and analytical side and this thought process, whereas Sherlock develops a bit more of a human side, a bit more understanding. And I think that's something that is easy to miss. Sherlock's ability to grow a heart, to say the least. He's very closed off, and I think that he opens up as time goes on. It's funny seeing his relationship views on women and marriage and why he thinks it's ridiculous, but it is funny that he has these thoughts, but he's also very understanding of how people are motivated by love and relationships. Now, this stuff I didn't like in this series, for the most part, are the massive flashbacks, because it's like a different story altogether. Three out of the four had massive flashbacks where they just reverse, go back 15, 20 years or whatever it is, and then they just show how this situation, this crime was committed because of this person's motive or the victim, what they did. And that is something I don't really like, how jarring it is. It's just so fast. It's like a chapter end and suddenly you're in another person's head, you're following a different storyline, and you really have to figure out what is going on. It is very effective in showing the motive, but I don't like how it just drops the mystery and goes into a different storyline. So that's one thing I did not like about this series, but I did really give them, I think I gave them all 4 stars. It was just such a fun series to read in so many ways, with the different clues that pop up, with the different characters. I also really love how the police aren't completely shown as idiots the whole time. They are sometimes idiotic, but that's also something where Sherlock is just so narcissistic that that's what he thinks. But then there also are times the police are very helpful and very intuitive, and I like that about them. Another thing about this is that I find the side characters to be a little simplistic at times, but I do enjoy the main creation of the storylines. Now, it's interesting that a majority of these events are created by situations that happened overseas, especially in the States. There are at least two of the four stories situations takes place overseas in the States. And then one of them is in India. And so it's definitely a world traveling kind of world for Sherlock Holmes, with his knowledge and such an international view of things. But that also then reflects the comments about other races and about other people, especially the one where it takes place in India. That was not a fun one to read. And that one was Sign of Four. So I really struggled with all of the racial slurs in Sign of Four. Now, I did really like, though, in Sign of Four, the extra layered elements of characters to this book, or to that book in particular. But all of them seem to have such an interesting way to look at things. And you can tell that time has passed between each novel because of the different, I don't know, personality things, and their time has passed between these relationships and friendships. So they've grown into their friendships, or they've grown into the relationships, and you can tell that. So I found it to be a very, I don't know, very comprehensive look at what maybe it could have been like if these two people really existed. Now, I know that Sir Arthur Conan Doyle is famous for Sherlock Holmes, and he really made the detective genre the thing. But I also am kind of disappointed at how short the novels were. I mean, I know if you compare them to other Victorian novels that are like 800 pages, they are very short at like 120 pages. But even then, they felt like short stories or novellas instead of a full novel. I wish they had been more in depth, because the one I think I liked the best, that's not true. I have in my head a ranking of the stories, and I think it goes from The Sign of Four, the fourth place, The Study in Scarlet for the third place, and then I'm not sure which is first, The Hound of the Baskervilles or The Valley of Fear, because on The Valley of Fear, I remember the twist and I loved reading it again, but I do recognize its faults. So I think I might be going with The Hound of the Baskervilles as my favorite. But because of that, I think the reason it's my favorite is because of its length. It was longer by a good 50 to 70 pages, at least according to my ebook. And I think that made all the difference, because it made these characters feel more alive, more real. It made the mystery more in depth and more engrossing. And I feel like the other stories suffered from a shortness aspect. And I really wish that these mysteries had been more fleshed out. They were wonderful, but they could have been so much more developed, more, I don't know, engaging to just pick up and read an extra 50 pages of this, of certain stories and how it was developed. I would have really appreciated that aspect in these novels. So I'm not really sure if I would say that this is the perfection, actually, I would never say that Sherlock Holmes is the perfect series because of its slurs and its jump cuts, maybe is the way to say it. But I do really enjoy the series, and I really enjoy these characters and how they grow. Obviously, they're based on Victorian times, and so things have to be expected and understood through that light. But I've got to say, it was really great reading these over the last 4 months, and I am excited to read some more detective novels this month for Victober. I have started The Woman in White, and I have just started a couple others as well, and it definitely shows me that Sherlock Holmes is just one of many characters of detective fiction, at least in the Victorian era. So I hope that you've enjoyed my thoughts on Sherlock Holmes. Please leave a comment down below if you've watched Sherlock Holmes, read Sherlock Holmes, what you think about Sherlock Holmes or any of the characters. Also, please subscribe if you would like to for more content from me, and I will see you next time with another video. Bye for now.